everyone, welcome to the Mystery Crew, and I'm Erica. Hello. So I decided to do audiobooks for you guys, and I have picked Enid Blyton as my author, and we'll be doing the series, the Barney Mystery Series. It's so exciting! Okay, the book I've chosen is the first one of their series called The Rocking Down Mystery. So let's begin with chapter one. Chapter one is known as the beginning of holidays. So here we go. Hello, Roger. Hey, Deanna. Had a good term. The boy and girl grinned at one another, half shy as they always were when they met again at the end of the school term. They were brother and sister, rather alike to look at, sturdy, dark hair, and determined chins and wide smiles. My train came 20 minutes before yours, said Roger. Bit of luck, breaking up on the same day. We usually don't. I waited about for you. Now we've got to wait for Mrs. Pepper. Diana groaned. She dragged her night case, her tennis racket, and a large brown parcel along with her. Roger also had a racket and a case too. These aren't going to be very nice halls, said Diana. With Mommy and Daddy away, and us back down in the country somewhere with Miss Pepper. And I wear my Mommy ask her to look after us. Why couldn't we have gone to Auntie Pam?
Because her kids have got measles, said Roger. Mrs. Pepper isn't so bad, really. I mean, she does understand how hungry we always are, and she does know we like things like sausages and salads and cold meat and potato with jackets and ice cream and ginger beer.
Oh, don't go on. You make me feel hungry already, said Deanna. What are the plans today, Roger?
I only know that you are going to meet me and we're going to see Miss Pepper somewhere. I had a letter from Dad yesterday, said Roger as they pushed their way through the crowds on the platform. He and Mommy sailed today to America. They had fixed up for us to go to Aunt Pam, but the measles knocked down the head. So Mommy wired to her old governess, Miss Pepper, and got her to fix up to spend the halls with us. And we are going to a little cottage somewhere that Dad managed to get hold of in Rocking Down. Goodness knows where that is. Where we are to molder all halls, I suppose, Diana said sulkily. I think it's too bad.
Well, there's a riding school not far off and we can ride, said Roger. And I believe there's a weir near. We might get a boat. And it's just good country all around, Rocking Down for birds and flowers.
All nice for you because you're mad on nature, said Deanna. I should be buried alive. No tennis, no parties. I suppose that horrid little snubby is coming too.
Of course, said Roger, digging some hard with his tennis racket.
Oh, sorry, did I hurt you? Don't let it get out of the software crowd, Ty. We seem to be going round and round in it.
You got into that one that's rushing for a train. Let them go by, for goodness sake. Look, here's a seat. Let's sit down for a bit.
When do we meet Miss Pepper?
Not for 24 minutes, said Roger, looking at the clock station. Shall we go and see if we can get an ice cream somewhere nearby?
Diana immediately got up from the seat. Oh, yes, what a brainwave. Look, there's the exit. There'll be a tea shop or something nearby. We'll get the ices there.
Over the ices, the chatter went on.
You said Snubby was coming, didn't you? Said Diana as she ate her strawberry ice.
Little pest!
Well, he hasn't got any parents, said Roger. That's pretty awful, you know, Di. He gets kicked about from one aunt to another. Poor kid, and he likes coming to us better than anywhere else. It's not so bad, if only he wouldn't play the fool so much.
Just a luck to have an idiotic cousin with an idiotic dog, said Deanna.
Oh, I like Looney, said Roger once. has quite a little body, of course, but he's a lovely spaniel. He really is. Lee is a wonderful name for him. He's an absolute lunatic, but honestly, his views are the things he does. I bet he plays Mrs. Pepper up. Yes, he'll go off with all her shoes, hide them under a bush, and fight her Sunday hat and get himself cleverly locked up in the ladder, said Diana. What about another ice? If Snubby was more of our age, it wouldn't be so bad, said Roger. After all, I'm 14 and you're 13 and he's only level. Quite a baby. Well, he doesn't behave like one, said Diana, beginning on her second ice. He behaves like a horrible little imp or goblin or something, always up to mischief of some sort and thinking he can tag us along. Oh dear, what with Miss Pepper and Tommy, these halls look as if they will be awful. Gosh, look at the time, said Roger. We shall meet Miss Pepper if we don't look out. We shall miss Miss Pepper if we don't look out. I must get the bill and we'll go. The girl brought him the bill and he got up with Diana to go to the desk to pay. As they were going out of the door, Roger glanced at Diana's hands. Idiot! You've left your racket and the bag at the table. I knew you would. You always do. It's a marvel to me if you ever manage to bring anything home safely. Blow! Said Diana and went to get her things, knocking over a chair in her impatience. Roger waited for her patiently, a grin on his good-looking face. Harlem's got him, untidy, impatient, die. He laughed at her, keep her in order, and was fond of her indeed. He was fond of his cousin Snubby too, with his impudence, sense of fun, and his habit of doing the most surprising and annoying things. Both Diana and Snubby would have to be kept in order these holidays, Roger was certain. Diana was cross and disappointed at being sent off with Miss Pepper to someplace she had never heard of. She would be annoying and perhaps sulky. Snubby would be more irritating still because he wouldn't have Roger's father to jump on him and yell at him. He would only have Miss Pepper, and Snubby hadn't much opinion of moving. Looney the dog, of course, another problem, but a very kind problem indeed. He was a dog who only obeyed one person, and that was Snubby. He had never outgrown his habit of chewing things, hiding them, and burying them. He went mad quite regularly, racing up and down the stairs, in and out of every room, barking his head off with excitement, and thoroughly upsetting every grown-up within miles. But he was so beautiful. Roger thought of the little black spaniel with a silky shining coat, his long drooping ears that were always went to his dinner dish, and his melting mournful eyes. How lucky Snubby was to have a dog like that. Roger always had smacked Looney hard for being wicked, but he had never ceased to love him. He was always glad Looney was there to share the holidays with them, even men having his cousin Snubby too. We gotta get meet Miss Pepper and the station clock, said Roger. We got a minute to spare. Look, isn't that her? It was. The children took a good look at their mother's old governess as they hurried up to her. She was tall, thin, trim, with straight gray hair brushed back under a small black hat. Her eyes behind their glasses were sharp and twinkling. She had a very nice smile as she saw the children hurrying up to her. Roger! Diana! Here at last, and punctual to the minute too. It's years since I saw you, but you haven't changed a scrap. She kissed Diana and took hands with Roger. Now, she said, we have a little time before we have to leave for our train to another station. What about a couple of ices? Or have you grown out of liking to them? Roger and Diana brightened up at once. Neither one of them said that they had just two ices each. Diana nudged Roger and grinned. Miss Pepper certainly was a good at remembering to provide ice cream and ginger beer and rest. She never failed at that. Now, I wonder where we can get ice creams without going too far, said Miss Pepper, looking around the station. Let me see. Isn't there a little tea shop just outside the station? Said Roger.
Yes, where they have lovely ices, said Diana.
Do you remember the way, Roger?
Roger did, of course, and promptly led the way back to the tea shop they had only left a few minutes before. Miss Pepper's eye twinkled. She wondered how many ices the two had already were still waiting for her.
Roger led his sister and Miss Pepper to a different table this time. He didn't want the girl to make some remark that would give them away. They ordered ices.
Where's Snubby coming? Asked Diana.
By train tomorrow, said Miss Pepper, with Loony a fear. I don't like dogs, as you know, and I like Loony even less than more dogs. It means I shall have to lock up all my slippers and hats and gloves. I never know such a dog for smelling things out.
Never!
Last time I stayed with your mother, Roger, I began to think Loony could undo suitcases because things I had put in disappeared regularly. I always found Loony with them sooner or later.
I expect Snubby had something to do with that, said Roger.
It was awful those halls you were there, Miss Pepper, as Loony as his dog.
Well, I hope Mr. Young will be able to keep Snubby in order, said Miss Pepper.
There was a sudden startled silence. Roger and Diana looked at Miss Pepper in alarm.
Mr. Young? What's he coming for?
To go to you all, said Miss Pepper in surprise.
Didn't you know? I expect you'll get a letter soon.
If you hadn't heard, your father rang up to your schools, you know, to find out what kind of a report you both had, because he knew he wouldn't get it before he left for America. And you gotta have coaching in Latin and math, Roger, and you in French and English, Diana.
Well, said the both children together.
How absolutely foul!
Oh, no, said Miss Pepper. Mr. Young is very nice and a very good coach. You had him before.
He's dry as dust, said Diana angrily.
Oh, I do think these holidays are hateful. Without Mommy and Daddy at a place we don't know anything about, with Mr. Young and lessons and...
Shut up, Di,
said Roger, afraid that his angry sister would say something about Miss Pepper too.
You know, we missed the whole of the Easter term because of scarlet fever. We are behind in a good many things. I meant to do some work anyhow these halls.
Yes, but Mr. Young, with his beard and his nips and his my dear young lady, cried Diana.
I hate him. I jolly well write and tell Daddy that I think of him for...
That's enough, Diana, said Miss Pepper in a sharp voice.
Is Snubby having coaching too? Asked Roger, kicking the furious Diana under the table to make her stop working herself into a rage.
Yes, unfortunately, he had a very bad report from the headmaster, said Miss Pepper.
That's nothing new, growled Diana.
And I ask you, can Mr. Young do anything at all with Snubby?
Snubby will lead him into a frightful dance.
Shall we have another ice? Said Miss Pepper, looking at a watch.
We have just time, or do you feel too upset to have another?
They certainly didn't feel too upset to have another ice cream and a ginger beer on top of that. Roger began talking cheerfully about the happenings of the last term, and Diana gloomed over her eyes for a minute or two and then cheered up too.
After all, it was holidays, and it would be fun to explore a new place. There would be riding and perhaps boating. Things might get worse.
Time to go, said Miss Pepper. We are having dinner on train. I hope you'll enjoy that. We shall be at Rocking Down by tea time.
Well, come along and cheer up, Diana dear. I expect you'll enjoy the holidays just as you usually do.
Whew!
Wow, that's chapter one. Such a pretty chapter. Ah, the English of Men in Blyden is so interesting to read it. So, I hope you like the audiobook and you support it and like it. And I shall see you in the next chapter. Bye!